talk about a few of the awards that we have for this. So, as I mentioned at the start of the concert, you can see some of these listed in the program. So we have solo ensemble cast is the first one I'm going to talk about. We've already given the student certificates, so I just want to ask them to stand to be recognized. So I'll read out all, I'll talk about the award and then I'll list the names. So the first thing is it's sponsored by the Minnesota State High School League, the same one that sponsors all the sports competitions. And we have a Region 5 AA contest. This year was at Irondale High School in March. And we had three students from this class that received the award. Tenia Gelpe is a ninth grader. Got an excellent. And then we have two members of the Cardinal Strings group, Peyton and over here, Michaela. And the two of them got a superior with Cardinal Strings. And then the other, which I will present. So we have lettering certificates, much like, again, that you find in other activities. What this represents for orchestra is that they're involved in orchestra, not just in class, but they're doing things outside of school that benefit them as an orchestra musician or benefit the orchestra program. So some of those things can include like being in fiddle club, a youth orchestra, private lessons, you know, helping out, setting up concerts, decorating at concerts. They could be doing many, many other activities, playing in their church, various other things that they might do, helping mentor a middle school student, things like that. So they get so many points for each thing, and the first 100 points, they get a letter. And then after that, for every 50 points, they get a bar. And those points are cumulative through their senior year. So there's a lot of students that earn points this year that may not be getting a letter. About half the students who got lettering points this year are working. They're going to probably by next year maybe get a letter. But there's a few students from this group, including one ninth grader that got a lettering award this year. So I'll read out the names. So first we have a senior whose first year in orchestra lettered an orchestra because they're also in band. They were in the All-State Band on clarinet. And that is Marie Carson. Then we have a couple of additional students who, this is their, they've been part of the orchestra program for a couple of years here, Logan Powell and Peyton Sharp. And rarely, but this happens we had a couple of students last year. We have a freshman this year who is in District Honors Orchestra, takes lessons, involved in a lot of fiddle club, a lot of activities here, Anna Moline. So every year, and we'll present a few more when we get to the concert orchestra, those students from that ensemble that are a part of that. So we have one more selection to play for you from this group. So. Thank you.
never know what it's like. You blood like wind free, just like ice. There's a cold warm light that shines from you. Your wand is like a wreck you hide behind that mask you use. And did you think the spook could never win? Well, look at me, I'm coming back again. I got a taste of love in a simple way. And if you need to know alarms to stand in, you just fade away. Don't you know I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time. I'm picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing, yeah. You saw another road leaving me again. Threats you made would let you cut me down. If love was just a circus, you'd be a clown by now. Don't you know I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time. I'm picking up the pieces of my life.
We have one more piece. If you want to go ahead. This one has a bass solo, so we sort of left us short a bass player. So I play bass once in a while, so I thought maybe I'd play bass with the chamber orchestra this time and have some fun playing with the students again. So we're going to switch places here, and then we'll get started. This next piece also has two movements. And so traditionally, there'll be a short break, but no applause in between the first and second parts of the piece. So. Thank you.
days, sometimes I think I'll never end. Sundays as heels to tie you, but look into the lake, shimmering like snow, faces the moon. Days went down just like a sinking ship. Days move down just like a sinking ship. Floating is getting harder. You look into the lake, shimmering like smoke, rises the moon. Days move up just like a tell you what you owe, but no, even so, rises the moon. You'll be visited by sleep. I promise you that soon the autumn comes, the dark and fading summer skies.
It won't be a surprise to tell you, can you?
I'm a whole nother. Thank you.
do a few, my voice is getting tired, getting a few awards here that I'll be presenting here. First, I forgot to put in the program, excuse me. We had a couple of students in Allstate this year, Sonia and Ephraim, but I forgot to mention we have a new student who's going to be in Allstate this summer, Matthew Tran here. So the three of you, why don't you stand up and be recognized. Minnesota is probably one of the most competitive states. I know that I've been a judge for many years for the bases, and sometimes they'll have as many as 25 people try out for like 8 spots from the state of Minnesota. So it's that's just the bases. The violins, I know, are even crazier. The violas. See if I can make it through this next part. Okay, so we remember we talked a little bit about contest, and so I want to recognize students who earned awards from contest. Again, they've received their certificates, but I just ask them to be standing. So I'm going to read the names off. We have Caleb got an excellent. Then we have Ephraim Superior, Ellie Superior. You can stand up. Tiffany, a Superior. Caleb and Morgan got a Duet Superior. Maria Carson, Jesse Coe, Ephraim Cooper, and Morgan Jordahl, all Superior. So stand up and let's recognize these students. So the next, we have several students on Cardinal Strings. I forgot to mention Cardinal Strings. Stand up for, yeah. Thank you. So we have quite a few students that were a contest on that day at Irondale. We also have several students that earned a lettering award. It's quite a long list. I have certificates for them. I will read their name out. And then have you come up to the front, and then I'll pass them out to you. How does that sound? Okay, just save a little bit of time. So Emily, Cora, Ellie, Yasin, and by Ashley, Ephraim, Tiffany, come on up to the front and line up across the front, okay? In the order that I just said your name, I'll start again. Emily, Cora, Ellie, Ashley, Yasin, Ephraim, it's alphabetic order, by the way, Tiffany, Kaylin, Caleb, Morgan, Maddie, Alyssa, Ellie, Sonia, Bajuda, Sam, Matthew, Thomas, and Susie. Come on up. Give them a round of applause. All these students. And as I said, and you'll see in the program it lists like somehow they got 2 bars. As I mentioned, 100 points for the first letter, 1 bar, for every bar it's 50 points. And these are just the ones that they earned this year, the bars. If it says 3 bars, 4 bars, 6 bars, that's just in 1 year that they earned that many. So if you do the math, let's see, 6 bars is like 300 points in 1 year. So there's some students that are super involved in doing a lot of great things. So. Okay, the next thing we have is there's some awards that we give out just to graduating seniors. We have 3 awards, the National School Orchestra Award that is selected by me, the Orion Award that is selected by the students, and then there's the Eric Matthews Memorial Scholarship in honor of a student who died 2 years ago. This would have been his senior year this year, and I have Lana Matthews, I believe, is here. is to present that award when we get to that part, and on behalf of the families, the foundation. So I am going to start with telling you a little bit about the recipient of the first award. And you can see, I left it in the box just because there's actually a little like lapel pin. I don't want to lose everything. But you can see it pictured up on the slide there. So, all right. I also have, there's a plaque on the wall, which is not hanging up right now because it has the new name. I didn't want anyone to see it before the night's concert. So it's in my office. I'll hang it back up in the orchestra room, and we honor all the students going back who's gotten those awards over the year. So, all right. This person was a member of the All-Conference Honors Orchestra. He's been a member of Cardinal Strings for 2 years, has done outstanding work as a section leader, has led with generosity, encouraging others to share the spotlight where there are solos in the music. Somebody who, when they perform, they have very mature and musical sounding, just a pleasure to listen to, somebody who plays beyond their years as a high school student. Somebody who's always makes it look easy, but makes it a pleasure to listen to, makes it look like it's not hard work, even though I know they've put a lot of work in to make it sound like that. This person was new to Coon Rapids High School last year. They were selected for the All-State Orchestra in this year and plans to attend UW-Morris. If you didn't already guess it, it is Sonia McGregor. This next award, the Ryan Award, is something that's been was established in 1948. It's been around for a long time. Remember when I first started here, it would just sort of show up. We don't even know who bought it. Now we have to pay for it ourselves. But it would just show up in my mailbox. I'm like, what is this, you know, thing? And then I go ask my, oh, yeah, I got one too. Yeah, you have to give it to a senior. Oh, okay. So anyway, it's a great award. There's a lot of amazing students over the years. Really look at the leaders in the program that represent this award. It represents an individual's contribution both as a scholastic as well as their musical work here. It also demonstrates a performing at a you know, very high ability and a lot of musicianship. This person contributes a lot to the community, will be missed when they're not here. They have a lot in common with Sonia here as well. This person's been an outstanding section leader, has taken numerous AP and honors classes, has been 3 years a member of Cardinal Strings, has also, with their leadership, inspires excellence in everything that they do, including the music. Someone who's made a difference in any ensemble and activity that they're involved in. You don't interact with this person and walk away not knowing who they are because they made a big difference in your life. There's somebody who's challenged me as a teacher to look for ways to improve myself and my teaching. And so I want to, this person, if you haven't already guessed who it is, this person's a member of Fiddle Club, Pit Club, Music Listening Club, Jazz Band, Guitar Club. I probably forgot a bunch of other activities they're involved in. And more music, just about a marching band. Oh, there we go. So if you haven't already guessed, oh, I should say, they were an honors orchestra, All-State Band, and going to Concordia Moorhead next year on a $92,000 scholarship. This year's recipient is Ephraim Cooper.
Watson said, my name's Lana Matthews, and and I'm very honored to be here tonight to present the Eric Matthews Memorial Scholarship. The scholarship is awarded to graduating seniors pursuing music-related degrees in college. It was created in 2021 by our family in connection with the Charleville Foundation to be a meaningful way for us to keep our son Eric Matthews' musical legacy alive. The scholarship was first awarded in 2022 after we tragically lost Eric on May 11th, 2021 during his sophomore year here at Coon Rapids High School. And like the scholarship winners I'll announce tonight, Eric would be graduating this year with his friends. So this evening is extra special and bittersweet for our family. So before announcing tonight's winners, I'd like to share a tiny bit about Eric. Eric was a passionate musician who loved everything about music, performing it, sharing it, and continuously learning about it. He loved discovering new composers and had his favorite well-known composers like Mendelssohn. He loved music theory and applied what he learned to create his own compositions. Eric's primary gift was playing the violin, but he was also a self-taught pianist with secret ambitions to play the organ and trombone. As a violinist in the orchestra here at Coon Rapids High School, Eric was a natural leader and a champion of his classmates. He believed everyone had the ability to improve as a musician, and he encouraged his classmates to grow and embrace new challenges. Eric's musical talent, passion, and kindness touched and enriched our lives, and he is missed very much. So now on to the scholarship winners. Our first award tonight is our honorable mention winner. This student is also a violinist who will be attending North Hennepin Community College this fall with the goal of transferring to St. Thomas University in 2 years. She is considering majoring in either composition or music production, although she's also interested in art and sound design and many other subjects. Her favorite musical style is the waltz in three-quarter time, which was also a favorite of Eric's. During the last 4 years at Coon Rapids High School, she has participated in Cardinal Strings, Honors Orchestra, Northwest Suburban Conference, and solo ensemble competitions. She also played with the Greater Twin Cities Youth Symphony and Minnesota Youth Symphonies in the past. When asked why she was applying for the scholarship, she said, "The scholarship means a lot to me and is motivation for me to push on in my musical career. So please join me tonight in congratulating the honorable mention and winner of a $375 scholarship, Miss Ashley Chung." Our second award tonight is for our runner-up. This student will be attending the University of Eau Claire this fall as a music education major. Her primary instrument is B-flat clarinet. However, she also plays bass clarinet, contrabass clarinet, double bass, trumpet, flugelhorn, mellophone, and French horn. She plays in both band and orchestra here at Coon Rapids High School and has participated in many extracurriculars such as marching band, pit orchestra, pep band, and Allstate. Outside of Coon Rapids High School, she has been a part of the Eau Claire High School Honor Band and has played with St. Gerard Church. When asked why she was applying for the scholarship, she said, "The Eric Matthews Scholarship means a lot to me. I was once very close to Eric, and I hope to continue his legacy by being as impressive as he was and by leading my students to be like him. Please join me in congratulating tonight's runner-up and winner of a $750 scholarship, Maria Carson." Our third and final award tonight is for our first place winner. And this student truly needs no introduction because everyone knows who this young man is. His primary instrument is the double bass, but he also enjoys playing electric and bass guitar. He's always a joy to watch perform since he's very animated and passionate about every piece he plays. At Coon Rapids High School, he has participated in Cardinal Strings, Fiddle Club, Pit Orchestra, Allstate, and Conducting Club, to name a few things. He was also a member of the Minnesota Youth Symphonies all 4 years of high school and has played with the Bethel Community Philharmonic Orchestra and the Visitation Orchestra in Mendota Heights. This person is a leader for his classmates and an encouragement to them as well, and he embodies the same passion for music and musicianship that Eric possessed. This young man will be attending Concordia College at Morehead this fall as a music education major, and when asked why he was applying for this scholarship, he said, "I'm not pursuing music for only myself anymore. Maintaining the passion and energy Eric had for music and our friendship is my biggest goal, and this scholarship would help me make that a reality. Please join me in congratulating our first place winner and the recipient of a $1,500 scholarship, the amazing and vibrant Ephraim Cooper." In closing, I'd like to thank each applicant who applied for this scholarship this year. Each one of you possesses a love and passion for music that is truly special. Again, congratulations to all three of our scholarship recipients, Ashley Chung, Maria Carson, and Ephraim Cooper. May all your futures be bright and musical. Thank you.
Thank you.